What up, what up, what up, fellow agents? Pure Prime here. Yes, my second build of TU10, and it's a PvP build. And combine these two talents, guys, and man, you're gonna have a lot of fun. Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for taking time and clicking my content. Really appreciate it. And today I'm gonna show you my PvP build. Yes, I made a new PvP build, or yeah, a TU10 PvP build. My boy Jason said, combine these attributes a little bit and then you're gonna have fun. I know the Bulwark is kinda meta right now, but this will take it down as well. I'm not saying this is a anti-meta build. I'm not saying this is the best PvP build out there. But after my boy Jay put me up to this build, I'm having fun in PvP again, guys. Nice. This is very, very enjoyable. Thanks again, Jason. Then, over to why this is so nice. We can put out a lot of damage and still have some survivability while using Unbreakable and the new backpack talent Adrenaline Rush. And this combination, guys, this is a very nice combination for survivability, and still, because we are using a red core critical hit chance, we're still hitting hard enough to take a lot of other people down that are up to that 2 million armor. But guys, that's enough of gameplay, I think. That's enough of me talking. Let's get over to the build. Yes, guys, this is the build. My first PvP build. And I'm rocking a 3-piece Providence, 1-piece Grupo, 1-piece Petrov, and 1-piece Overlord. Overlord and Petrov, of course, for the best in slot pieces to get as much damage as possible. And went for the grenade launcher. Why? Because I love to shoot the grenade launcher, especially in conflict when you have that special ammo. It's very nice to blow people up. And it will give me some protection to fire, 20%. The third reload is a little bit faster. That's very nice in battle. When my armor is depleted, all my main weapons will get refilled with the ammo. That's very nice as well. And you can skip one explosion every 60 seconds. That's why I chose this specialization, but there are a lot of other specializations you can go for. For example, with the gunner, that gives you a little bit more armor when you heal up with a medkit. But let's head over to my guns, guys. I'm using the FAMAS and the Eagle Bearer. Starting with the FAMAS, I rolled 15% assault rifle damage on there, and it already has 21% health damage and 6% damage to armor and strained on there. So yeah, this is pretty much god roll, and in a very, very nice way, because I love strained on there, especially with PvP. Of course, you have killer that gives you that 40% instant after a kill, but in PvP you're not killing that much, not that much as in PvE. So in my opinion, strained is the way to go for a talent on a PvP gun, especially if you're building a crit build just like I have. Over to my Eagle Bearer. It can be a little bit better as the core attribute, but I'm fine with it. I'm not always using the Eagle Bearer. I love to play with my FAMAS, so I can roll it again, but it's pretty decent for now. Over to my 3-piece Providence, guys. Starting with the mask, 14.7% weapon damage, 5% critical hit chance. Rolled 12% critical hit damage on there, and 11.4% critical hit damage as a mod. And this is very nice. Why I'm doing this? Of course, for the headshot damage, that 10% critical hit chance, and that 50% critical hit damage. Over to my backpack for the second piece. 15% weapon damage, 5% critical hit chance, 8.2% explosive resistance. Would love to see some critical hit damage there, but it's still nice, protects you from some explosive or a little bit. And then 11.3% critical hit damage as a mod, and the new talent Adrenaline Rush on there. And this is a very good PvP talent, guys. especially when you come close to the enemies, because whenever you are within 10 meters of an enemy, gain 10% bonus armor for 5 seconds. Stacks up to 3 times, and the cooldown is 5 seconds. So yeah, it's a very nice PvP talent, guys, especially when you come close to other enemies. And if you're shot from a distance with a rifle build or whatever, you always have Unbreakable. Unbreakable chest has 12.1% weapon damage, 4.8% critical hit chance, 10.4% critical hit damage, and a mod of 11.4% critical hit damage on there. Unbreakable on there, whenever your armor is depleted, repair 50% of your armor back. And this is good again, or this is decent again in PvP. This is very nice. I'm getting my armor back, so I have almost 2 lives again. Almost. Because I will get around 30% armor back. With that 50% armor from the Unbreakable, gives me 80% armor back if it all stacks up then, of course. So you almost got 1 life back, and that's very nice. Over to the Grupo. Why Grupo? Critical hit damage. We're making a crit build with, of course, some survivability on there. So 15% weapon damage, 5% critical hit chance, and 10.7% critical hit damage on there. And then over to the Overlord knee pads, guys. There is a little UI problem. As you can see, critical hit damage is 12%. It's maxed out, but the bar won't show it at this moment. So this is an all maxed out Overlord knee pads with, of course, that 8% damage to target out of cover on there. And this is very, very nice. Although I'm not using a rifle, that damage to out of cover is still doing a lot for me. Over to the Petrov gloves. Again, UI problem. 12% critical hit damage is the max. Don't know why the bar is showing this, but again, a maxed out best in slot gear for that 8% damage to armor. And again, not using an LMG, but it will give me that extra damage, guys. Believe me, this hits very, very hard. And then for the skills, guys, over to the Restore Hive. It will give me a refill speed of 5 seconds, 16 charges, a range of 6 meters, and the health of 41.6k a charge. So this is pretty decent. This will give me around 600k armor back, around that. So this is pretty nice, but it will take a while. It gives me, and of course, I'm doing it for my teammates as well, so you're not always getting all the charges. Then over to the Reinforcer, the cam launcher, the heal cam launcher, heals me up to 117k. And let's head over to the stats, guys. Let's see. We got a PvP, a weapon damage of 37.5k, 54.8% critical hit chance, and 166.2 critical hit damage. And that's without strain, guys. That's why I'm hitting so hard and still have that survivability. 70% headshot damage, 14% damage to armor, and 21% damage to health. Then over to the offensive, 90.8% all weapon damage bonus, but we can combine that with assault rifle damage bonus of 30%, so we have 120.8% all weapon damage bonus. And that's pretty nice, guys, that's pretty nice. But that's pretty much all for the stats. The armor or everything around that, the defense isn't that high because we are stacking into a red core, of course. Of course, we got that 30% burn resistance, but the rest isn't that interesting. So this is my build, guys. Just like I said in the intro, this isn't the meta. This isn't the best PvP build out there, but I think we got a lot more combinations now. Of course, that bulwark can be a little bit annoying if it's all maxed out, but still, this build took it down as well. Not saying it's the meta, but I'm enjoying this. But for today, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.